Today's July 5th, 2024. I'm Tata Gasawara, and this is MobileViews Mini Vidcast 46. I'm here with my good friend Jared Kuroiwa, who has put up with my foolishness, as many of my friends do, fortunately, to help me test this new camera that I just got in. It's called the OBSBOT. Let's see, what is it called? OBSBOT Tiny 2 Lite. It's described as an AI-powered 4K webcam. You can kind of see it in the screenshot behind me. And so right now, I'm using the camera sitting on top of my new Microsoft Surface Copilot PC. And also, it's built-in microphone. And so I'm going to switch now. I'm going to switch just the camera to the Surface's front-facing camera. So this is the Surface's front-facing camera. Same lighting. It's about 2 inches away from where the OBSBOT is sitting. And then I'm going to switch the microphone to the Surface microphone. Oh, actually, I was on the Surface microphone, sorry, in both cases. So I'll leave it here for now. And now I'm going to switch the camera to another 4K camera that I've been playing with called the UVC40. And that's sitting to my side. So that's a different angle. You can tell the lighting is different. I'm going to switch the microphone to it so you can hear the difference. Okay, this is the UVC40 microphone. It's a little bit further, maybe 6 inches further away than my Surface and OBSBOT is. And so this is I'm going to switch now to the OBSBOT microphone. Okay, now I'm on this is confusing, but I'm on the other 4K camera. And this is OBSBOT microphone. I'm going to switch the camera back to the OBSBOT. Okay, this is the OBSBOT. Okay, this is OBSBOT again with its own microphone. So the first time I was on, as we began, it was the OBSBOT camera, but the Surface mic. What do you think? Could you tell the difference, Jared, as I was switching between microphones? And the cameras obviously are really different.
Yeah, definitely the audio is different.
Really?
The other external camera, it sounds a little more tinny. Mm. The Surface one's not bad. The OBSBOT one seems to have a little bit more bass. So I don't know if that's a setting in it. Yeah, it's got a little deeper tone to it.
Yeah, in fact, I probably should have brought in my Nano, my Yeti Nano, with a good microphone to test against. In fact, I'm going to go do that. So I have just, I'm back in frame, and I'm going to plug in, I'm running out of ports. So I've got a Yeti Nano sitting in front of me, and I'm going to see if it sees it and if I can switch to it. Yep.
Sadly, it didn't, the audio's not working.
So that was interesting. It said my when I plugged my Yeti Nano in, it still wasn't working, and I don't know why. But I'll try it again. This is a good enough test, I think. Because really, I want to know if I can get away with not using a lot of gear when I record. One of the things I found out is that the Surface itself, its camera is pretty good. I think it's really good. I think I don't need another camera besides it. It's also very wide angle. So I'll switch to the Surface camera. There we go. Here we go. We're going to switch to the Surface front camera. And you can see it's a really wide angle shot, that Surface camera. It has an array microphone, which is pretty decent, better than my UVC40, I think, but not as good as my Yeti Nano. And I'm kind of disappointed. I will say, I could not get this OBSBOT to work plugged into a hub, USB-C hub. It's plugged directly into my Surface. I don't know if I haven't tested it with any other computer, so I don't know if it's because it's a Snapdragon or some other oddity, but that was a little disappointing.
Could you move a little closer to the camera?
Sure. This is the Surface camera.
Okay. Yeah, the quality of Surface camera is good. When you sit back, I think it's color distorting slightly, and I'm not sure if it's like
might be because my non-professional lighting and all of
yeah.
that. But I'm gonna go. I want to do some other stuff. I'm gonna grab the manual because I'm not sure I remember this. So the AI-ness of this. There are a couple of things that I apparently need to install some software, like the beauty filter, which I know I need a lot of. I haven't installed the software, so it doesn't apparently do that. But it does have some gesture controls. So this is a 2x zoom. I don't know if you can go in between. And you do this again, and it goes back out to its widest angle. And see, is it tracking me?
No.
Okay, right now it's not tracking me. Let's see. There's a dynamic zoom. I think it's this. Oh no. Oh, that is something else. Let's do this. Will this go back out? Okay. I think if I do this, so it may not be obvious to you, but I am moving my head and shoulders about a foot and a half, and the camera is actually swiveling on an axis. I think if I stand up, yeah. it'll actually track me up and down too.
It looks like you're on a boat.
It looks like I'm on a boat, yeah. It's really meant for people who do, It's really meant for people who are doing like an exercise demos or cooking demos or something where you're a little bit further, really a wide angle shot, and you want it to track you within, you know, some field. So I don't know. I think it's pretty good. It's really small. I just wish it had a carrying case. So it comes with a pretty long, I think it's about maybe a meter, maybe a little bit more than a meter, USB-C to USB-C cable, plus a USB-C to USB-A adapter, which doesn't work in my hub for whatever reason, but at least it works when it's directly plugged into my Surface Pro. And I don't know. What do you think, Jared? You've been kind of watching me blather on.
Yeah, no, it's pretty good. I think the mic distorts a little when you go at the distance.
Like this?
Yeah. I'm not sure if it might be adjusting to ambient noise if you go that far. I don't know.
Yeah, it is supposed to have some kind of noise cancellation built in. In fact, when we began talking, my neighbor across the stream, which is it's across and about maybe 70 feet, 80, 90 feet diagonally from me, had like a maintenance crew, I think, doing some, you know, yard work. And so they had those leaf blowers on. But you said you didn't hear much of that, if any, right? So that's pretty impressive because it was loud. I thought, oh, great, just when I wanted to test something. But so I'm pretty happy with this. I should also note I do have a little light facing me that's also clamped. I'm going to move it so you can see this. So I've got this light clamped onto my Surface. So I do have artificial light on. It's supposed to work pretty well at low light. In fact, I'm going to turn off the light. So. I'm kind of faded. So it is right now, it is about 1:30. I'm in a house, but there's light coming in behind me, so I'm backlit, which probably doesn't help. So I'm going to turn that on. And I manually moved the camera. So, okay. Is it still tracking me?
No.
It stopped tracking me, actually. Let's try that again. Now it's tracking me. Okay, that's fun. All right, so this is not a real, let me rephrase that. For what it does, it's not a real expensive camera. I think it's pretty pricey for somebody who just wants to chat with their friends and family now and then. But I think it's about $180 list, which is not cheap by any stretch of imagination, but for all the features it has with the dynamic zoom and the gesture zoom and apparently a built-in beauty filter if you run some software with it. I'm pretty happy with it. It does have a 1/4-inch screw on the bottom so that if you don't want to just rest it on the edge of the laptop like I'm doing right now, sitting on the edge of my screen, right near the built-in camera, not blocking it though. I had a tripod here in case it didn't
reach over.
I have a tripod right here that I was going to use if it didn't actually stay on my laptop as some cameras are wont to do. Like the other 4K camera does not balance well. It's also twice the length of it. So this is really nice and small. I really have, again, that's it right there behind me in giant size. That's about it. What do you think overall? Okay.
Yeah, I like it. It's pretty cool.
Yeah. All righty. So this has been MobileViews Mini Podcast 46. I want to thank Jared for, as I said, putting up with me and jumping in on this impromptu test. But I really, really wanted to get a chance to check out, do an ABC test with the built-in camera, the UVC40 4K camera, this camera, and also do some microphone checks so I can decide whether or not I can live without, you know, hooking up a nice microphone all the time. I think I still have to hook up a nice microphone all the time. That's my belief now. All righty. All righty. So July 5th, 2024, we're signing off from this one.
All right. Take care.